Hello everyone, this is Dr. Raj Singh. I practice here in Las Vegas, Nevada. We have a medical practice where we do a lot of bioidentical hormones, and I'm often seeing a lot of mistakes being made, especially when it comes to applying topical creams. So that's the purpose of this video on how to apply creams, and more importantly, what are some of the top mistakes when applying hormone creams. So let's get started. So mistake number one, applying the cream to the outside skin. So, you know, like for example, outside, this skin is too thick here, so it will not get absorbed. Always, always apply it on the inner skin because the outer skin is too thick, so you won't get the right results. Mistake number two. So the mistake number two is applying cream to a very small area. So make sure that you apply cream at least 6 to 8 inches size, you know, at least about this. You know, maybe follow your hand, you know. Now if you have unusually tiny hands, maybe go buy a dinner plate, but you have to apply to a large area for it to get properly absorbed. Mistake number three, applying at times when the skin is not clean, you know. So best is to apply first thing in the morning right after a shower, so it will get absorbed very, very quickly. Mistake number four, applying estrogen cream to the breast area. This is absolutely contraindicated. Remember, estrogen can stimulate breast cancer, so if applied to the breast area, you could have breast tenderness, but more importantly, it could stimulate a breast cancer. So that's a no-no when it comes to estrogen creams. Mistake number five, applying the cream to forearms. I've seen some videos actually saying that you can apply it to the forearms. I don't like the method because the risk of transferring the hormones to those around you by direct skin contact is just so high. So inner arm, inner thighs, torso for men are better options. Mistake number six, using a cream every single day. So for testosterone creams, I would recommend you using 6 days a week, skip a Sunday. You know, that keeps the the hormones, that keeps the receptors hungry, let's put it that way. When it comes to estrogen creams, you can use it from day 1 to day 25. That could be your menstrual cycle, or easier to follow is to just calendar month. So January 1st to 25th, apply the cream every single day, then don't apply it for the next 5 to 6 days, and then start again February 1st. This minimizes possible side effects, keeps the receptors hungry, and it maintains a natural rhythm of your hormones, which is the whole idea behind replacing these hormones. Mistake number seven, trying to save the cream, you know, by not using the prescribed amount. You might be running low on the medication, call your doctor, get it filled, but don't use less than what you prescribe, because the dosing amount is based on your hormone levels. So use the right amount. Mistake number eight, getting blood drawn to monitor your hormone levels. You know, remember, medications applied to the skin, they do not travel, they do not get to the bloodstream. They travel through lymphatics and are quickly utilized by the cells. So the blood hormone levels will not change. Saliva testing is ideal. Another would be to do a, what we call a capillary blood spot testing when it comes to monitoring your hormones when you're using creams. Mistake number nine, not rotating the sites. Do not apply to the same area every single day. You know, rotate the sites so you get the best possible results. Okay. Mistake number 10, not rubbing enough. When you are using the cream, you gotta rub it for at least 1 to 2 minutes so it gets absorbed fully. Now, that also reduces the risk of transferring it to your clothes or somebody around you. Mistake number 11, you know, exposing the cream direct to sunlight. Don't keep it outside, don't leave it in your car. You know, the hormones will lose its potency, you won't get the optimal results. So keep the cream in a dark area. So that's all for the video today. So thank you for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe. And of course, if you did like the video, you know, do press the like button. That keeps me motivated so that I can make more of these videos. Thank you very much.